Hi friends, welcome to Tech ARK IT YouTube channel. My name is Ravi. In this video session, we are going to see about RHCSA examination 200 EX200 Red Hat certified system administration course. So this is a complete certification course. I'm going to start from today now. So from daily, I'm going to update one video and which tell you that entire certification content, what are the content is required for the certification, and can also be guide you to set up your own lab environment, your at your home using your laptop or desktop, whatever it is. Then you can continue with that practice and you can do that. So here, what is that RHCSA and who needs to learn? So if you can go to the Red Hat certification, Red Hat site, and in that there is a certification, in that you can click on the RHCSA certification. So it gives you the details. So what does it mean by the RHCSA and Red Hat certified system administration? So who need to learn this course? Okay, so the course can be learned by the experience in the Linux administrator who is seeking their validation for the skills. In the sense, they have the skills, but how they can prove that they have the proper skill set? So they can write the certification so that they can prove themselves, say that they has the experience on this Red Hat Enterprise Linux system by managing their system, all the stuff, and you can validate using that certification skill set. And students who have attended the Red Hat system administration, like the one or two, like just they went for the training, they wanted to write the certification immediately, they can do that. Experienced system administrator who require a certification either by their organization or based on mandate. So maybe like some people, they request, like organizations, they request for the certification. You can also go with that certification for doing this. And who are IT professionals who are in the path of going with the the base certification is RHCSA. If you certify this, then you can go for RHCE certified engineer certification. Okay, so if you want to write any certification, so the base certification should be an RHCSA. So that's why you have to write this certification first, then you can write the next level of the certification. So anyone who are looking into the career in the Linux platform or the open source platform, or they also looking for some programming background or app development, all the stuff, they can also learn the Linux. So what are the skills you have to learn to earn this certification? This certification, you require to understand and use essential tools handling the files, like creating the files, removing the files, modifying the content, creating the directories, their permissions, and understanding of the command line environment, and also understanding internal documentation stuff, like how you can get the help without internet, all the stuff. And operating systems, like installing operating system, if any boot issues on the operating system, you have to troubleshoot that. And configuring the different types of run levels are the and identifying the processes, what are the processes are running on the system, all the stuff. And creating the virtual machines using the KVM, and controlling services, and managing the virtual machines, all the stuff. So these are the course content you have to learn, but they're given in a few lines. But if you elaborate each and everything, so it makes a lot many topics. So SELinux stuff, and firewall, managing the users and groups, okay, including the centralization, directory authentication, like LDAP and Kerberos authentication stuff. And you can also creating the shares, like network file systems, and all the stuff you can learn in the certification. And how this certification is going to be? So this certification is going to be entirely in a practical session. So the radar center will give you a what they will give you, in the sense they will give you on a system, okay, which is installed with operating system called Red Hat. Then from there you have, they will give you then a question paper on the system itself. Then you have to do whatever they say on that question paper, which means that they will give some questions like configure this thing or configure that thing, all the stuff. Then you have to configure it and give it to the examiner. Then based on your configuration, they will validate and provide you the certification. So here there is no multiple choice, there is no writing methods and nothing. So it's completely in a practical session. You have to do it on the system. So the easy method to earn the certification from the any authorized center or the from the Red Hat, you have to practice. That is only the good mantra for earning the certification on the Linux. So hope you follow this course and do practice. Okay, set up your lab environment following by my next videos. That's about this video. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned. Please subscribe to the channel for more upcoming courses and videos. Stay tuned. Please follow us on social networking sites. If you have any technical related questions, you can ask